Again that white, weary scorn radiated from him. Joan bit her tongue to keep from screaming. How could she live under this torment? It was she, Joan Randle, that had earned that scorn, whether he knew her or not. She shrank back step by step, almost dazed, sick with a terrible inward coldness, blinded by scalding tears. She found her door and stumbled in. "Kells, I'm what you called me," she heard Cleve's voice strangely far off. "There's no excuse, unless I'm not just right in my head about women. Overlook my break or don't, as you like. But if you want me, I'm ready for your Border Legion." End of chapter 11. Chapter 12 of The Border Legion by Zane Grey. Those bitter words of Cleve's, as if he mocked himself, were the last Joan heard, and they rang in her ears and seemed to reverberate through her dazed mind like a knell of doom. She lay there, all blackness about her, weighed upon by an insupportable burden, and she prayed that day might never dawn for her. A nightmare of oblivion ended at last with her eyes opening to the morning light. She was cold and stiff. She had lain uncovered all the long hours of night. She had not moved a finger since she had fallen upon the bed, crushed by those bitter words with which Cleve had consented to join Kells's Legion. Since then, Joan felt that she had lived years. She could not remember a single thought she might have had during those black hours. Nevertheless, a decision had been formed in her mind, and it was that today she would reveal herself to Jim Cleve if it cost both their lives. Death was infinitely better than the suspense and fear and agony she had endured. And as for Jim, it would at least save him from crime.